All right, now that all the sound editing stuff's out here, I'm gonna show you guys this stuff one more time before I put it in there. The converter's already got a quart of fluid in it. I was gonna flip it over and show you the bolt pattern, but one thing you need to make sure you do is test fit the converter, the bolt pattern from the flex plate to the converter. I did that. I actually had to make these holes a little bit bigger. This being the PTC converter uses a 7/16 bolt, and I don't think that the holes in this were ever intended for that. So I had to open those holes up a little bit before I get all the bolts started. I'd have been really upset if I wouldn't have noticed that until I had the flex plate, you know, torqued in the car and the trans made it up to the engine before I noticed that. So definitely make sure you check that kind of thing before you get that far. But that's done now. I've got my package of flex plate bolts. So I'm gonna climb back under this thing and torque the flex plate in there and then slip the converter in the trans and bolt the trans up for the last time. So. Okay, so the trans is in here now that I have four bolts in the bell housing currently. I have to put the rest of the bolts in it. But I've got enough in it and tight to make sure the trans is in place. It's just sitting on the mount and back. One of the things you need to check, and you always need to check this, is the converter, the clearance between the flex plate and the torque converter. Rossler's spec is they want they want an eighth inch for their two-speed power glide stuff. They want typically an eighth, between an eighth and 3/16, right? So they want an eighth for their power glide stuff and 3/16 for their turbo 400 stuff. This being a turbo 400, we want 3/16 of an inch. So they show, you know, a lot of people show you doing this with a drill bit. I prefer to do it with Allen wrenches because you got a little bit of a handle to get in there with it, right? So I stick this 3/16 one in there. Check that out. Tons of room, right? So I also have a quarter inch one here, and that fits in there, but it's tight, right? Like it fits, but it's in there, it's tight. So we need to figure out the difference there, which is like, 3/16 is 187.5 and then a quarter inch, right? So whatever the difference between those two are, and then get a shim, and you put that shim on the flex plate side here. You don't want to pull the converter out, obviously, so you need to shim it back there before we do that. So I'm going to finish putting the bell housing bolts in this thing, actually tighten the trans crossmember bolts in here. You can see I've only got one bolt in each side. These bolts are extremely long currently because they're meant for that factory thing's like an inch and a half thick. So I'm going to cut these bolts down so they're a more proper length, more appropriate length. I'm going to torque this stuff in here and get the trans mounted it in there so that side of it's finished before I move on to shimming the converter stuff. I just wanted to show that tolerance to you guys, so you just, if you're doing this yourself, you know to check it, right? So I'm gonna keep moving. Okay, now that we got the trans is 100% in, converter bolts are tight, and the shift linkage is hooked up and adjusted. I gotta remember to do that with the shifter in neutral, right? So if you're doing that, keep that in mind. So the next thing we gotta do is put this slip yoke in. Now this is a strange piece. It's a billet cap, removable cap deal. It's a U1678N. This is a hardened yoke. That's due to the roller bearing tail housing on that Rossler Turbo 400 in this. So that is our front piece. So when you do this, when you set, or when you're measuring drive shaft length, you gotta put this all the way in the yoke, all the way up to the seal, or all the way in the trans, all the way up to the seal, and pull it out an inch. Typically that's, you know, 7/8 to an inch to an inch. Pull it out there. That's where you're gonna wanna put this in here to measure your drive shaft length. So I'm going to do that. And we still have to install this. This is a, again, another strange piece. This is a U1596 is the part number for this. We're gonna put this in the back, which is gonna convert the flange. If you're familiar with the flange on the S197, it's a bit weird back there. So we're gonna put this in here, that in there, move that out an inch. Then we're gonna set the thing up to ride height. Once we get it at ride height, I have to check and possibly adjust pinion angle. Once we get that stuff all done, we'll be able to measure our drive shaft length and get that sent off to a friend of mine that's gonna build the drive shaft for us. So I'm going to get these in there, get the car at ride height and check pinion angle, and we'll go from there. Transmission was down 2 degrees. The pinion at the rear end was up 1, which is where we want it. So measured drive shaft length. I had a couple, the person who's doing my drive shaft gave me 2 different ways to measure it. So one was pulling the yoke out an inch, measure between the split point of the cap at the housing, and that has a, you know, the billet cap at the yoke as well. So I was measuring between the 2 split points. Gave me 51 1/16, and then if I measured from the split point at the back to the transmission tail shaft seal, it was 54 1/16. So I got 2 dimensions to give those guys for making the drive shaft. The splines on the end of the transmission between the, like, basically the back of the tail shaft and how far the splines stick out of the trans was another dimension they asked for. That was 5/8 of an inch on this. Obviously, if you're having a drive shaft made by somebody, get, you know, ask them what they're wanting for dimensions and if they have a sheet for you to fill out, that kind of thing. But that's it for this one. I'm going to show you my trans cooler real quick, because that's going to be the next video we're going to do. I got a bunch of stuff on it. Just a derailleur piece here. Comes with their rubber hose and push lock stuff. Move this for you so you can see everything. Yeah, it comes with their rubber hose and push lock fittings. These are kind of not really a push lock. I'm assuming there's a barb in here somewhere. I haven't pulled these out, obviously, to look, but I'm not gonna use this stuff. I'm gonna use normal, probably ProLite 350 hose or something like that. And then here's the cooler itself. Nice fan, nice shroud. Kind of deal. I'm hoping to mount this in the back of the car. In the next video, I'll figure out a spot and we'll get that thing mounted and work on getting it plumbed. Once the drive shaft comes back, hopefully that'll be in the next video too. I'll be putting this cooler on and we'll be putting the drive shaft in it as well. Sorry. If that's the case, if we get the drive shaft in it and the cooler on it, got a couple wiring things I'm sure I'm gonna have to sort out as far as the how the neutral safety switch was ran with the factory ECU, that kind of stuff. But once we get that sorted out, get the car running, I want to put it back on the dyno, on the stock ECU still with the turbo 400 in it, and do a couple hits at the last time I had the thing on the dyno with the 6R, it was 14.5 pounds, made it a little over, I think, 850 to the tire, something like that. So I'm going to go back there with the turbo 400, this converter, on the same tune-up with the same boost level, and see what kind of power loss we see. I'm assuming it's gonna be a power loss just because of the non-lockup situation. I don't expect it to dyno well with this converter. Just nature of the animal, right? But that should be an interesting video as well. So yeah, so don't forget to subscribe and follow along with our build as we prepare for the 2021 season, and hope you guys liked it. Anxious to get this thing going again, so should be cool.